بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم ربنا بلغنا ليلة القدر، اللهم إنك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا، اللهم اعتق رقابنا من النار برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us and gift us to reach the ليلة القدر, which might be tonight, inshallah. Accept our deeds, save us and shield us from the doom of the hellfire, and pardon us, he loves to pardon, subhanahu wa ta'ala. The protection of the heart, as we have mentioned earlier, will help you to keep one's emotion safe and be focused, and have to have that tranquility that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned many times, and especially in Surah Al-Fath that we were reading. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala قال أنزل السكينة في قلوب المؤمنين ليزدادوا إيمانا مع إيمانهم. And he said قال فعلم ما في قلوبهم فأنزل السكينة عليهم. قال, the people of Jahiliyyah, they have the hamiyah in their heart, this arrogance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had descended his sakina on his prophet and the believers. The sakina is this tranquility that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bestow upon whom he will. And this tranquility is one of the forces of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is a power, it is a force. And the sakina, it might be someone, you know, possible for them to get kind of time of tranquility, you know, by all the, let's say, the ways that people they do is either meditation or entertaining or enjoying, you know, a lot of things. But this special sakina actually comes in the heart in the very, terrifying moment, in the time of the hardship, when it's not possible for someone to get the sakina. So even someone with the serenity has as a believer will not be able to have it, because when someone, for example, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the example being at war, it's really terrifying. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help that sakina when you are not able to have this tranquility. Allah put it in your heart. Have this sakina to descend in your heart. So Allah mentioned the sakina as one of junudullah, as a forces. So it's a force to get into your heart, to increase your iman, to make you dynamic, to be positive, to be optimistic, to see things, you know, in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is one of the great results of protecting your heart, and protecting your heart, as we have said. So احفظ قلبك يحفظ الله سبحانه وتعالى همك. And then the next part of the saying of this great salaf رحمه الله تعالى قال احفظ علمك يحفظ عزمك. Protect your knowledge. Safeguard your knowledge, which is mean have the focus on the true knowledge that it really help you in this life. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you to have the azm. The azm is that, you know, this determination to work, to be active, to have that strong willpower that is effective, productive. How it comes with the ilm. And this ilm is the ilm of the Qur'an, the ilm of the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the ilm of life, the knowledge of life. The knowledge of life. Because there is ocean of knowledge. But the priority of the knowledge, to get the knowledge will help you get safe to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the first priority of knowledge. Al-Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah ta'ala summarized this knowledge in four elements. When he was asked about the wisdom that he is following, the secret, people they call this, you know, the secret recipe of happiness. Here the secret recipe of happiness of Al-Imam Al-Hasan Al-Basri that he gets from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the sunnah of his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first one, قَالَ عَلِمْتُ أَنَّ رِزْقِي لَا يَأْخُذُهُ غَيْرِ فَاطْمَأْنَنْتُ بِهِ. I have a certain belief that my provision, nobody else can take it. Nobody else. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decreed your provision before your creation, before the creation of the heaven and the earth, and being reiterated when you were in the womb of your mother, and the angel, they say, this is his lifetime provision, income. عَلِمْتُ أَنَّ رِزْقِي لَا يَأْخُذُهُ غَيْرِ فَاطْمَأْنَنْتُ بِهِ. I have the certain belief that my provision, my income, nobody will take it. Then I feel so tranquil. I feel calm. I feel have full tranquility, you know, toward my rizq. If there is no rizq, I'll be patient. But because why is coming? وَفِي السَّمَاءِ رِزْقُكُمْ وَمَا تُوعَدُونَ. In the heaven is the rizq and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised in you, subhanahu wa ta'ala. And tu'adun, it has, you know, more depth in explanation. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "Fi sama'i rizqukum." So this, your rizq, it's not, you know, in a corporate X or the corporate way. The rizq is in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَهَذْ ذَا اِطْمَأْنَان. Just, you know, make a strive in a way to bring tranquility to your heart toward the rizq when you think is in the hand of Allah and nobody else can take it from you. Just say like I compete and race, someone he took it and he should not have done this. No, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And sometimes, subhanAllah, there's two types of rizq. There's the rizq, the tangible rizq, and then the hidden rizq. We're talking about income like tangible money. Yeah? Because the rizq is infinite, and the best of the rizq is the guidance. There is, you know, tangible rizq that you see increase your account. You see it, you know. Your account becomes like more fat. May Allah, you know, make your account, you know, in the fast month of fasting, make your account to be fat, inshallah. Inshallah, he says. There's the rizq. That is hidden rizq. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect what you have by not having, for example, any of the kids to be, you know, to fall sick, for example. Or yourself to get sick. Or something happened, the car stopped, break down. So subhanAllah, all what you have as a saving is going to be taken by repairing this car, doing the thing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect your car, protect your health, protect your family. That's a rizq, because it was going to be spent and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saved it for you. Therefore, that increase of the rizq, but you don't see it. That's why you need to be constantly in the hamd of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He's always providing you, subhanahu. That's the first one. The second one. قَالَ عَلِمْتُ أَنَّ شُغْلِي لَا يَفْعَلُهُ غَيْرِي فَاشْتَغَلْتُ بِهِ. I know I have tasks in my life. Nobody else is going to do them. Your prayer, nobody going to pray on your behalf. Your sadaqah, nobody's going to give a sadaqah. Your prayer, your work at work, nobody going to do it. So that's why subhanAllah comes from the believer, that spirit of excellence, to do everything the way it needs to be done and make it to be perfected. Because not only he or she does what the task that they have, but they do it in full completion and perfect. That's the spirit that the Prophet ﷺ is teaching us. So when you work and you do all your work that you have, from your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the relation with your family, to the relation with the people, that's because if you don't do it, you're going to be accountable for it. So when you do your work, alhamdulillah, you feel good. The third one. قَالَ عَلِمْتُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ مُطَّلِعٌ عَلَيَّ فَأَسْتَحْيِي مِنْهِ. I am certain that Allah is watching me. Then I feel shy from Allah. I don't want Allah to see me doing, violating His way, or doing a sin. No. And this is the muraqabah. عَلِمْتُ أَنَّ اللَّهَ مُطَّلِعٌ عَلَيَّ فَأَسْتَحْيِي مِنْهِ. Imagine you have one of your elder in the family, how you respect the person. Many think even mubah, lawful, you don't want to do them in front of this elder because of out of respect. For what do you think of Allah is watching you? The fourth one. عَلِمْتُ أَنَّ الْمَوْتَ آتٍ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ. فاستعددت له. I know that death is coming with no doubt. Then I'm getting ready to it. This four make you the happiest person in the world, and you make you queen for the sister and king for the brothers. To have a tranquility toward your rizq, because in the hand of Allah, to act and work with excellence and perfection, as the Prophet ﷺ told us, because nobody else will do your work. And to be shy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as He's watching you, and to be ready for death, because you're created for the eternity, and you cannot access to the eternity only through the path of the death, the vessel of the death. For may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descend on our heart tranquility and increase our iman, and help us to be faithful in our oath and covenant with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa ila salati arhamukumullah.